Francis Bacon. Thesis of Atheism. I had rather believe all the fables in the legend and the Talmud and the Alcoran than that this universal frame is without a mind, and therefore God never wrought miracle to convince atheism, because his ordinary works convince it. It is true that a little philosophy inclines man's mind to atheism, but depth in philosophy brings man's minds about to religion. For while the mind of man looketh upon second cause scattered, it may sometimes rest in them and go no further. But when it beholdeth the chain of them confederate and linked together, it must needs fly to province and deity. Nay, even the school which is most accused of atheism doeth most demonstrate religion. That is the school of Leucippus and Democritus and Epicurus. For it is 1,000 times more credible that 4 mutable elements and 1 immutable fifth essence, duly and eternally placed, need no God, than that an army of infinite small portions or seeds unplaced should have produced this order and beauty without a divine marshal. The scripture saith, the fool hath said in his heart, there is no God. It is not said, the fool hath thought in his heart. So as he rather saith it by rout to himself, as that he would have, then that he can thoroughly believe it or be persuaded of it. For none deny there is a God, but those for whom it make that there were no God. It appeareth in nothing more, that atheism is rather in the lip than in the heart of man. Than by this, the atheist will ever be talking of that their opinion, as if they fainted in it within themselves, and would be glad to be strengthened by the consent of others. Nay more, you shall have atheists strive to get disciples, as it farthereth with other sects, and which is most of all, you shall have of them that will suffer for atheism and not recant. Whereas if they did truly think that they were no such thing as God, why should they trouble themselves? Epicurus is charged that he did, but the symbol for his credit's sake. When he affirmed there was blessed nature, but such as enjoyed themselves without having respect to the government of the world, wherein they say he did temporize, though in secret he thought there was no God, but he certainly is transduced, for his words are noble and divine. There is no profanity in refusing to believe in gods of the people. The profanity is believing of the gods what the people believe of them. Plato could have said no more, and although he had the confidence to deny the administration, he had not the power to deny the nature. The Indians of the West have names for their particular gods, though they have no names for God, as if the heathens should have had their names Jupiter, Apollo, Mars, etc., but not the word Deus, which shows us that even those barbarous people have the notion, though they have not the latitude and extent of it, so that against atheists, the very savage take part with the very subtlest philosophers. The contemplative atheist is rare, a Diagoras, a Bion, a Lucian, perhaps, and some others, and yet they seem to be more than they are, for that all that impugn a received religion or superstition are by the adverse part branded with the name of atheist. But the great atheists indeed are hypocrites, which are ever handling holy things, but without feeling, so as they must needs be cauterized in the end. The causes of atheism are division in religion, if there be many, for any one main division at its zeal to both sides, but many divisions introduce atheism. Another is scandal of priest when it comes to that which Saint Bernard said, one cannot now say the priest is as the people, for the truth is that the people are not so bad as the priest. A third is custom of profane, scuffling in holy matters, which doeth by little and little deface the reverence of religion. And lastly, learn times, especially with peace and prosperity, for troubles and adversities do more bow men's minds to religion. They that deny a God destroys man's nobility, for certainly man is a kin of the beast by his body, and if he be not of kin to God by spirit, he is a base and ignoble creature. It destroys likewise magnanimity and the rising of human nature. For take an example of a dog, and mark what a generosity and courage he will put on when he finds himself maintained by a man who to him is instead of a god or better nature, which courage is manifestly such as that creature, without that confidence of a better nature than his own, could never attain. So man, when he resteth and assureth himself upon a divine protection and favor, gathered a force and faith which human nature in itself could not obtain. Therefore, an atheist is in all respects hateful. So in this, that it is depriveth human nature of the means to exalt itself above human frailty, as it is in particular person, so it is in nations. Never was there such a state for magnanimity as Rome. Of this state we hear that Cicero saith, pride ourselves as we may upon our country, yet are we not in number superior to the Spaniards, nor in strength to the Gauls, nor in cunning to the Carthaginians, not to the Greeks in art, nor to the Italians and Latins themselves in homely and native sense, which belongs to his nation and land. It is in pity only, and religion, and the wisdom of regarding the providence of the immortal gods as that which rules and governs all things, that we have surpassed all nations and people. Thank you for watching. And as always, there's more information provided in the links below. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and share.